So I mentioned before that acids release H plus ions. Similarly, bases, instead of releasing H plus ions, they take up H plus ions. Okay. So they take up H plus ions and acids release H plus ions. So if you want to say in terms of releasing, then bases release OH minus ions. Okay. Now, if you look at the pH scale, what can I say is a strong base? If I say, give me the pH of strong base. What will it be?
12 to 14.
What is it?
12 to 14.
12 to 14.
14.
And if I say weak base?
8 to 10.
8.
8 to 10. Very good. Okay, so 8 to 10 is weak.
What is
And
11?
so it is between weak and strong. Okay. All
Yes.
right. So, yeah, so these are weak bases and strong bases. But remember, you can only measure the pH when it is in its liquid form. You cannot measure pH of something in its solid form. It has to be in its liquid form. So when you convert bases into its liquid form, they are called alkalis and they are alkaline in nature. So more alkaline, then it will be, if a substance is more alkaline, then it'll have a pH of 14. If a substance is less alkaline, it has a pH of 8. Okay? Is that clear to everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, very good. So now let's look at some examples of bases. Okay? So this is an example. These are some examples. Yes?
Ma'am, what does ION stands for?
What? Ion?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so ion is any atom or molecule that has a charge. For example, H plus, for example, hydrogen ion, for example, hydrogen atom. Okay. Hydrogen atom does not have any charge. But if I put a charge on that hydrogen atom by taking away one electron, if I take away one electron from that hydrogen atom, then it ends up having only one proton. That means it will become a H plus. So any atom that has a charge, any atom or a molecule that has a charge is called an ion. Does that make sense, Karthik?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, cool. Is butter a base? Butter is not a base, Arna. And why it is not a base? I know you're saying it because it's slippery to touch and soap. It's slippery, not soapy, but slippery. But it is not a base, and you will be able to answer this later on in the class when you learn more about ionic bonding and covalent bonding. You will understand why it is not a base. Okay. Yes, Veda, 12 to 14 are stronger alkaline substances. Ma'am, I read that RO water is acidic, not alkaline, and it is unhealthy. So you read
Ma'am,
that RO water is unhealthy. Oh,
I want
one second, Veda. Just hold on
to ask. Oh, okay,
that
ma'am.
question. Advait, so I don't know the answer to this, but I will do my research and I will. Thank you for asking that question, because every time I don't know the answer to something, I also learn. So I will find out about this, okay? And I'll tell you in the next class. Okay, Advait? Okay, Veda, you can ask your question now.
Yes, ma'am. I wanted to ask in basis, why is it that 8 to 9 is weaker and 12 to 14 stronger? Because in acids, 6 is weaker, the bigger number is weaker, and 0 to 1 is stronger. So why is it the opposite in
Very,
basis?
very good question, Veda. Excellent. Okay, so let me tell you why. Okay, so look over here. Okay, so what did I tell you is the definition of bases? Bases, they take up H plus ions, right? So remember I told you pH means power of hydrogen. pH means power of hydrogen. That means more number of H plus ions are released, it is more acidic. Okay, so now if I go back to the scale and I tell you this is releasing more number of H plus ions. Okay, this is releasing more number of H plus ions. So let me draw an arrow like this. So this is releasing more number of H plus ions and this is taking a lot of H plus ions. Okay, so this is taking a lot of H plus ions and this is giving away a lot of H plus ions. Sorry, hold on. So this is giving away a lot of H plus ions and this is taking a lot of H plus ions. So whatever takes, whatever bases take more H plus ions, they are stronger bases, and whatever gives away more H plus ions are stronger acids. Does that make sense?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the more number of H plus ions it gives away, it becomes stronger. So this arrow over here, right, the arrow that you see, basically this arrow, this is the direction in which H plus ions are given away. So the further back I move on this arrow, the more H plus ions it keeps taking. Okay. So that is why it becomes a stronger base.
Okay.
Oh, ma'am, can you read this one again?
Okay. So what did I tell you is pH? What is the full form of pH?
Ma'am, the
power of hydrogen.
pH means power of hydrogen. Okay. Okay. Before that, there are, I'll get back to that. Delisha is asking some question. Is slime a base? Slime is not a particular substance as such. Like you can make slimes out of different things. So it depends what you make slime out of. But usually I would say, yes, Veda.
I just wanted to say that usually we make slime with eye contact solution. Like, you know, the lens solution which you use to clean eye contact. So, and then you can also use salt. And so, those are all, I think those are all, I'm not sure if they are acids or bases, but I feel like if we are making them out of acids or bases, it can be it can be an acid or a base, because sometimes slime, you know, it burns your hand, kind of.
Yeah, but so usually whenever you have a cleaning agent, right, cleaning agents are usually basic in nature. Okay. Okay. So Delisha, yes, Priscilla.
In slimes they use borax. So what is borax exactly?
Borax?
It's a detergent. A detergent, so it's basically a base, I think. Because it's a cleaning agent. So
yeah, so it's like white and powdery. I think that is what you use on top of carom board also, right?
It's
a
detergent powder.
It's detergent powder
for like washing clothes.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So what was your question again? I think I lost the question.
I think she was asking that is
slime consists of like borax powder. So
then that is basic, yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay, so, all right, so lots of questions. Let me take this one at a time. Delisha, is slime a base? So if slime contains borax, yes, it is a base. It is basic in nature, okay? Delisha, okay, is slime and clay a base? Okay, first of all, ghee, oil, cheese, all of these, they are not bases. And I will tell you why they are not bases. They are what is called as covalent compounds. Okay, and covalent compounds are not bases. And they are neither acidic, they are not basic either. Okay, so you will learn this later on. I will have a quiz at the end of this and I'll explain to you what that means. But no, oils, cheese, butter, all of these things that we eat, right, most of the things that we eat, those are usually not acidic or basic. Of course, we have lemon and all of the fruits and stuff, which are naturally all of this. But oil and cheese and stuff, those are neither acidic nor basic, because those are all covalent. They are all made out of carbons and hydrogens, and I'll explain that to you later on. But to answer your question directly, it is not. It is neither acidic nor basic. Okay.